In this episode, we'll start building a metal foundry that we'll use to make motorcycle parts. Hi folks, I'm Custom Chess for Roma Custom Bike, and we're starting a new project that I am sure you will appreciate. We're going to build a homemade metal foundry for melting aluminum, brass, copper, or whatever you decide to put in it. Before starting, I'd like to remind you that all my shades are courtesy of Wiley X. These are the same glasses worn by the US Marines, and they're bulletproof. They've even sent me one of the lenses that they've used for ballistic testing. It has been shot with a shotgun from a distance of 10 meters. Can you imagine? If they're good enough for bullets, they're definitely good enough to protect our eyes while riding or even in the shop. Now, let's get down to it. What is a foundry? A metal foundry. We have gone right to our friend Wikipedia that states, a foundry is a factory that produces metal castings. Metals are cast into shape by melting them into a liquid, pouring the metal into a mold, and removing the casting after the metal has solidified. Now, this is a factory process that we're trying to bring into the home, and for starter, we need something to melt the metal in. So, let's begin with writing the recipe for the perfect homemade foundry. Just like a good cook, I've prepared all the ingredients we'll need to build our foundry, starting from the IKEA vase that we'll use to house it. This alone, though, won't be enough to contain the crazy high temperature we'll need to melt our metal. So, using this big blue bucket, we'll mix together some refractory mortar, like this stuff used for building fireplaces, some construction sand, like this, and some good old water. We'll use this mix along with some steel wool, for structural reinforcement, to line the inside of the vase so that it can withstand the infernal heat we'll put it through. Now, we'll also be needing something to form the empty space inside the foundry, and this protein powder jug is just the right size for the job. To bring the temperature up to specs, we'll be using a propane blowtorch, and to gain access from the side, we'll use this hole saw to cut a hole on the side of the foundry. Inside we'll have a steel crucible, a container to hold the melted metal. This one has been built just for this project by my buddy Polsky Raid. So, if something goes wrong, we all know who to blame, right? Now, to maximize performance by keeping the heat inside the furnace, we'll be making a top cover. And we'll use some more of the refractory mix we have used for the lining, a large bucket, and two U-bolts, like these ones, used to secure satellite dishes, and we'll use them as handles. Now, last but not least, I've also prepared some painter plastic, because I'm pretty sure that this is gonna get messy, and I'm keeping my trusty fire extinguisher handy, because with Custom Chess, you never know what's gonna happen. In just a few minutes, I'm ready to make any kind of mess I want. Now, since we've talked about recipe, let's start with the ingredients. We're going to put in 3 parts of construction sand, 1, 2, and 3, followed by 3 parts of refractory mortar. We'll drop it in the bucket slowly because it's pretty volatile. 2, and 3. You can see through the bucket the 2 equal amounts of material. And finally, we can add 2 parts of water. 1 and 2. Very bubbly, just the way we like it. Now, it's time to put some elbow grease into it. For this task, I like to sport a pair of dishwasher gloves. You know, safety first. I feel a bit like a witch making a potion, but it's all for a good cause. Make sure to break any lumps you might feel in the mix. This stuff is pretty sticky, and lumps are no good. After a bit of mixing, I feel that I've reached the consistency I need. Now we can prepare the bucket for the pour. As I've mentioned in the beginning, I'm going to use some steel wool for structural reinforcement. We can look at it like if we were putting in some tiny rebars, just like in reinforced cement. Then I fill with water the protein jug that I will use to make the center void in the mold. The weight of the water will help keeping it down, otherwise it would flow to the top of our mixture. Then it's time to add the steel wool that will fortify the sides of the foundry. I should probably have spread the strands a bit more, but we'll see that later. For now, we can start pouring the mix into the bucket, slowly and trying to reach every nook and cranny. Lifting the jug a bit ensures that we get some material underneath it as well. Then I add some more steel wool and some more mix.
You go to school, don't be a fool. Every child is meant to do great things in life. You'll see one day. Don't do drugs, don't just love. Don't do anything that makes you happy. It will pay up one day. You will get your share one day. You might get your share. You'll be
I could have really used a vibrating table to get rid of all the air bubbles, but a few strokes of a tool will have to do for now. It's a good time to give it a little wipe. It's much easier to do it now rather than later when the mix will be hard. Then the jug is secured in place with a bunch of tape and it's ready to be put aside to dry for a while.
What it takes to get it on. What it takes to...
The mortar package suggests to allow 24 hours for the mix to be fully cured. So now we have the time to do the molding of the top cover. Before getting to it though, let me just take a second to thank you all for the support you demonstrate every day by hitting the like button, by sharing our videos on your social networks, and by subscribing to our channel. Now you can click on the little bell to receive a notification when I publish a new video, so you can see it as soon as it's out. I'd like also to invite you to visit our site www.romacustombike.com, where you can find our unique accessories and our t-shirts, because nothing is better than posting in the real world. The process is exactly the same, starting with the steel wool and with the same mix we used for the bucket. This time I've used a piece of pipe for the center hole and have submerged the two U-bolts in the mix so that they can serve as handles once we're done. Once again, I make sure that all areas are nicely covered with the mix and I try to release all air bubbles from the mold. At this point, all we can do is wait. We're gonna need a little patience. Two days have gone by since we poured the mix into the mold, and I'm pretty sure that it's hard enough for us to open it and see what we got. Let's start with the easy one, the lid. By jiggling it a bit, all things get loose and we can already use the handles to extract it from the bucket. It looks like everything went okay, and now we can remove the center pipe. It takes a little bit of manhandling and a little bit of hammering to get it out, but nothing too crazy. In a few minutes, the pipe is out and the lid is ready to go. The mold is so accurate that even the price tag was transferred onto the mold. And yes, the blue bucket was 550 euros. Forget about it, I'm getting bankrupt over here. Now it's the vase's turn. It will be a bit more complicated, but nothing that we can't handle. I start by dumping the water from the jug. I don't need it anymore. The key is to try to collapse the plastic jug onto itself, so to extract it from the mold. Easier said than done, so I decide to butcher it by cutting out the neck and the curves, all parts that give it more structural stability. After snipping off a few pieces, the jug comes out pretty smoothly, revealing the inside of our brand new foundry. As you can see, there are a few places where the mixture didn't manage to saturate properly the steel wall. Probably the best solution would have been to soak the wall in the mixture before inserting it into the bucket. That would have guaranteed an optimal penetration. If you attempt this project, and you shouldn't, just like I mentioned in the disclaimer at the beginning of every episode, then you should remember this detail, but don't. Don't do it. You have been warned. Understood? Okay. What our foundry needs now is an opening for the propane torch. The power drill and an old saw make this a very easy task. I'm cutting it at an angle so that if we have catastrophic failure of the crucible, the upward angle will help contain the molten metal that will spew inside the foundry. Good, we have a nice little hole, and the good news is that we're done with the build. The top fits perfectly and so does the crucible inside. Most of what you've seen until now has been inspired by the super awesome videos that Grant Thompson made on this subject. If you don't know him, please make sure to check out his channel. He's called King of Random. His videos are great, but I felt that I could add a little bit of my touch to this project and bring it to the world of motorcycle and custom enthusiasts with a little bit more of detailed information. I hope you enjoyed it, and this is just the beginning. In the next episode, we'll test the new foundry and we'll start melting aluminum, hopefully like the pros. Well, our clock is running out and I'm very satisfied with what we did in this episode. And what do you think? Let me know by visiting my Facebook page called the Roma Custom Bike ENG or by commenting right here on YouTube. I'd like to remind you that along with subscribing to the channel, you can also visit our site called www.romacustombike.com to find the accessories we've been producing and our t-shirt. That's it for now, I'm Custom Chess for Roma Custom Bike, and I'll see you next time.